Modern smartphones have to strike an odd balance between performance, thermal output, and battery consumption. And normally, when a user's purchasing a device, these are the last things on their minds. My name is Colt McCandless, and unbeknownst to game devs, these physical properties of a phone can manifest into some really weird performance issues. You see, all modern mobile CPUs have a process known as frequency scaling. That is, in order to conserve battery, the hardware will reduce the amount of voltage supplied to the CPU depending on a variety of factors. This dip in supplied energy helps reduce battery consumption as well as thermal output, but has the downside of slowing down your CPU in the process. Now, there's a variety of factors that can cause this behavior, but there's two of them that you need to know about. The first type of frequency throttling has to do with the load capacity of the CPU. If your CPU is chugging along and then suddenly hits a consistent run of low compute frames, the CPU governor, which is the thing that controls the frequency, can reduce the frequency supplied to the CPU, reducing its computational power and thus saving energy. Subsequent frames, of course, will run a bit slower since there's less power being given to the CPU, which means you'll see your frame time go up. This creates a problem, however, once your CPU load returns back to normal. Since the frequency has been downscaled, you could end up with large performance spikes since your CPU has been running slower. This performance hit will continue until the CPU governor decides to upscale your frequency back, at which case you should be back in your original state. The good news is that this type of throttling is entirely under your control, and you can address it before things go badly. By timing your CPU frame, you can easily detect when consistent lulls in CPU load occur, and for the next few frames, add some work to ensure that the CPU is getting artificially pegged at the right frame rate. This will keep your CPU from scaling and reduce your spikes in your frame time. By the way, things like spin loops are particularly nice solutions that help chew up frame time, or you can do something more awesome like pathfinding for 200 zombie entities. But that's really another episode. Thankfully, your Android device reports the amount of frequency scaling that's occurring on your device, so you can determine if this is actually a problem. To get access to this information, simply read a few files from an oddly cryptic system path, and you can determine if you're getting artificially scaled or not. Now, the second type of throttling is a little bit more difficult to deal with, since it has everything to do with the thermal properties of the client device. See, one of the dominant trends in mobile computing has to do with heat distribution. Typically, on desktop CPUs, they have this obnoxiously large heatsink fan attached to it, specifically to get rid of heat and keep your computer from melting. Now, in contrast, mobile devices don't have the amount of physical room for such a powerful heatsink and have to find different ways to distribute heat. And more so, each manufacturer likes taking into account different thermal properties and use cases for their designs. For example, some Android devices are built to handle long-term gaming, while others expect more moderate levels of usage and may not provide enough airflow or sink space to get rid of heat effectively. As such, once the thermal let-off becomes a problem, the CPU will become throttled to help reduce the amount of heat being generated by the hardware. The end game here is that, eventually, due to form factor or running duration, your CPU can get overheated and then throttled and remain that way until the heat properties of the device return back to normal operating values. And once this in this state, your CPU frame time is going to suffer. Now, generally, there's no good way to be reactive about this type of throttling, as it has much less to do with your code and more to do with the thermal properties of the device, unless you're doing something really crazy like trying to do protein folding on someone's handheld, in which case, shame on you. Proactive developers will collect performance characteristics about the devices that their game is run on and can reduce computational complexity, features, or quality for those devices. But even then, that's a lot of work to do to avoid this thermal problem. Of course, the first step in fighting any type of thermal throttling is aggressively optimizing the performance of your game to ensure that you're not wasting battery, frame time, or thermal let-off on your consumer's device. So as always, keep calm, profile your code, and remember, perf matters.